Hello, Tristian. Zuriel, spare me a few minutes. You are the ruler of these lands, and I don't dare to tell you what to do. But I just can't stand silently and watch what's happening behind your back. Oh no. There are rumors on the streets of a savage goddess enraged by your appearance in her lands. Well, there's probably the nymph. They say she cursed you, and now you bring woe and death to everyone around you. This used to be just idle talk, but now, when we are surrounded by so much death and suffering, the people are ready to truly believe it. And it seems that someone is playing upon your subjects' fears. Well. Huh. I saw barkers in the streets telling citizens of a prophet who is building his own kingdom. According to them, the goddess stands ready to grant forgiveness to any who cleanse themselves of the curse, but this cleansing is accomplished through a terrible, cruel death. Well, that sucks. These horrific deaths involve a wild beast appearing from inside the body, and they think it's a blessing. What the fuck, is this Alien? It's the new Alien movie, yes. Okay, let's see. That insane old man, Remus, he also spoke of some goddess. True, Jaw told me of that preacher. Who knows, perhaps his words touched people more deeply than anyone imagined. Shit, what is this kingdom the prophet is building? This is like actually Witcher now? I don't know. Witcher with more kingdom management for sure. I'm pretty sure Geralt did never have to rule a kingdom and like spend 3 months in the kingdom just to like advance his subjects ranking for like random stats like military and stuff. I only heard fragments of conversation. I think it's not a kingdom exactly, more like a community. Oh, a cult. Oh. Yeah, remember the guys I just killed? And one of them actually turned into an owl cat, right? An owl bear. Yeah. Probably what this is about. I'm afraid that we'll need to find one of their barkers and ask them if we wish to find out more. Huh. Let's see. Yeah, it's absurd and dangerous for the people to consider death a blessing. We must get to the bottom of this. Good. Perhaps after uncovering this mystery, we will find out more about the nature of this curse, of the curses happening, hanging over the stolen lands. I mean, there must be a reason that these cultists shout about you receiving the goddess's punishment. If we wish to understand, we must find out those barkers and learn from them all we can. Sadly, these street preachers scare quite easily and avoid our gods. I'll begin my search without delay. When you find time, look for me on the streets of the capital. I hope that when we meet, I will have already found someone who can tell us more about the strange goddess and her followers. I'm like 95% sure that it's about a nymph. Like maybe she's actually building like a rival kingdom now. With maybe like, I don't know. Like people who actually died and turned into creatures. Then at some point she's trying to attack me. Why, would you look at that? Svetlana sent you a letter. It seems she's worried about old Bokken. The letter is very emotional. What? The atmosphere is very close to the book and to the first Witcher game. Oh, you actually read the Witcher books? That's cool. A letter from Svetlana. Your Grace, I hope that matters of state in this land of ours are indeed all fine and well, and what troubles there are don't weigh too heavily upon your mind. I write to ask you to check our local herb doctor, Bokken his name. The poor old man is losing his mind. He spends all day and night stooped over his cauldron. He looks about to lash out at anyone, especially those he doesn't know. He even snarls at me and Arlek, which he'd never have let himself do before. Please come and see him before the old Karjan loses his mind completely. May Aristeel save him. We have no one to turn to but you. Hoping you come as soon as possible, I remain yours truly, very truly yours, Svetlana Leviton. Well, that sucks, because Bokken is my alchemist. I don't want him to turn crazy. That's shitty. That is very shitty. Should take care of that. By the way, thank you, Doriel. I did the man thing, as you said. Feel relieved, happy, and sometimes a bit sad. Oh, shit. Well, I of course don't know what exactly happened to you, dude, but just like from my very own experience, like taking care of stuff head on is always the best thing. Like it can slightly hurt you in like the moment when it happens and you actually have to do it, but it would be far worse to basically try to, you know, like just delay the stuff. And maybe even try to not address it at all. Like, if you do that, it basically always sucks later on. So, it's always good just to be like, oh yeah, okay, let's just do this. And eventually, you know.
No mistake.
Stuff will work out after a while, or... Or it will just go away, you know. Like, some stuff is bound to happen that will basically always end in like situations where it's basically a lose-lose situation, and you can't really get out of that with like a feeling of, you know, you've actually done something great. But yeah, it's still better to always just do things as soon as you can. So I wonder what's going on with Bakken. Cause I just told him to make me another magic item. I don't know if that actually... Maybe it's my fault? Maybe it's my fault that he's turning crazy? I don't know. It's probably just coincidence. Like, I would assume this just happens at this point in the game. Okay, so right now... I think... we are... good. Yeah, everyone is busy. So I guess we'll head over to the trading post again and see what's up with Bakken. No idea what his problem is right now, but I guess we'll see. It's weird how you speak generally, but like, help me out a ton. I had a lot more speed friends help, it's cool. Like, so cool to have so many support, huh? Yeah, dude, it's not just you, though. Like, don't feel awkward about that. It's just, like, sometimes, no matter how strong of a person you are, sometimes you just want people to give you, like, a small push on the back, you know what I mean? Like, Sometimes you already know what you have to do, but you want people to tell you, yeah, you're right, that is what you need to do. And that just helps you to do stuff and feel better about it. And that's how it is for everyone. It's not a random strange thing that is only true for you. Like, it's totally normal. Don't worry about it. How do you EB in this game? I'm trying really hard to find, like, some speed mechanics in this game, but I don't know, dude. Didn't find it yet. Who's there? What is it? Can I now refer to you as my senpai? Well, I guess. As long as I'm older than you, then it's fine. I'm pretty sure I am older. Oh, it's you. How convenient. I need your help. We have to run some tests. Tests? What tests? I have found the formula. All of my own. Oh, shit. So this happened because I did that with the books. Whoops. I guess it's my fault after all. I have found the formula all on my own. These damn books didn't have it. Nothing but hints and half-truths there. But you can't fool old Bakken that easily. What formula? The elixir of eternal youth. Uh-oh. A most wondrous brew. Restores the strength in one's hands and the swiftness in one's feet. I first heard of it when I was still just a lad, and I didn't believe in it, but now I have lived a long life and I have seen even stranger things, so I thought, why not you give it a try? So I asked you to find these books for me. I'd heard that one of the volumes contains a formula. Well, it turns out they don't. So all I did was... for nothing. Cool. All they do is make things clear as mud. Still, I was able to find something useful in there. Oh, I can't remember how many nights I stayed up working on the solution, but here it is. Can't drink it yet, though. Must test it first. Can't be too careful with these things. So will you help me? Elixir of Eternal Youth. I wonder. Yeah, I wonder, like, if I decide to help him, will this actually lead to him giving me, like, a really cool kind of potion that I can use? But then maybe he turns out, like, as a crazy fool and it will basically, I don't know. It'll be something bad in the end. Or what if I try to stop him? I guess... let's try to be the responsible guy, I guess. No, Bokken. Svetlana is worried about you, and I can see she's right to be. You are obsessed with this idea. It won't lead anywhere good. But that's how it is it? That mischievous schemer. Fine. I'll just make it on my own. It won't be the first time. Shit. Oh, fuck. Oh. You guess I'm like 24 or something? No. I'm older. I shouldn't help people, huh? I don't know about that. So basically I just screwed up this quest, huh? I think this was a bad choice. Like, Yeah, I'm gonna try to help him actually. Cause it seems like even if I say, come on dude, people are worried about you, you should stop. He's still gonna do it anyway, so I might as well try to help him and make sure he doesn't do anything, you know, anything really stupid. 28? Nope. 56? No, I'm younger than 56. Yeah, I'm actually 56.
All according to plan.
I also got very obsessed with the Elixir of Eternal Youth. And at some point in my life, I actually found a formula for it. That's why I look so young. Alright, I'll do it. Wonderful, thanks for that. Let's try it on a dog first. There's a mud on a leash around the corner. You can test the stuff on it. I won't feel bad for it if something goes wrong. What the fuck? He's an asshole. That'll teach it to stop barking at me every time I pass by. I could do it myself, but what if it's off the leash? It won't harm you as it would harm me. What the fuck? I'm not tormenting living creatures for the sake of your ambition. Fuck! Dude! This sucks! They really want me to be... I don't know. I'm starting to doubt. I'm starting to doubt that this quest is a good idea, but... Yes, I'm younger than 56, but older than 28. Yes. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna save my game. I'm gonna do a quick save right in front of him. Yeah, I don't know about that. Like, I hope this is not gonna turn out as like a bad thing to do. Which dog is he talking about? I guess it's not this dog. Also, why the hell are there in two embers? Oh. Random rabbit. Oh, there's the dog. 30? No. That is also wrong. Oh, there we go. Okay. So see, if I actually give this dog the potion, it would be an evil thing to do. That's pretty much what I thought. Because, yeah, I wouldn't want to do that. So I guess we untie the dog and let him go. Okay. Goodbye. Bye-bye. Now what?
That is not far.
One thing is for sure, if this will also make the quest fail, then I don't care. Because I'm not gonna do anything to the dog. Oh, we can bluff. Okay. Oh, this is great, yeah. We can lie and say that something bad happened to the dog. As soon as I fed your potion to the dog, spots appeared on it from head to tail, and then it had orange saliva dripping from its mouth. Orange saliva? But wait, what's that then? This potion wasn't meant to make such changes to the body. To the demons with the dog. We need someone more human to experiment on. You know what? My neighbor, a hunter, once told me he saw were-rats in a forest not far from here. Oh yeah, I know where they are. They'd make better test subjects. After all, they are closer to humans than a dog. We should find them and try again, but take this vial. This potion has a different, improved formula. Oh boy. Oh boy. Is 30 too old? Ha, that would be easy. I'm sorry, dude, but nope. 30 is too young. I am older than 30. But I'm glad you guessed 24. That means I'm still looking, you know, fresh. Yes. The fresh face. Will it tell me which forest, which area they want me to go to? Shit. It doesn't say, does it? Fuck. Nearby woods. I forgot. Oh, fuck. I thought the were-rats were like somewhere around here. Were they not? Shit. It's okay, dude. I'm 32.
I need to catch my breath.
Yeah, shit, I don't know. I don't know exactly where these words were. Shit. Well, he said in a nearby forest, right? So maybe... I guess we just check out old locations again. I don't remember exactly which area it was. Respite? I'm pretty sure I killed them all. Yeah. Didn't I? I remember it was like a really hard fight in the early game. With like one spellcaster whereat. Who gave me like a really hard time. Oh, this is
all according to plan.
Is this where the troll was? I think it was. Not too sure. Yes. Yes, you won, Jo. You won. You were totally right. There is no way I'm going to find this. It's not the Technic League encampment. It's not the Temple of the Elk. It's not the lair of the Tusk Gutter. And this stuff down here might already be too far, right? What was Thornford? That's where the... Yeah, that's where I met these bandits. That can't be it. It's not the ancient tomb. So maybe this oak thing?
Tire.
Oh! There we go. It's a totally new location. Well, makes sense that I was confused. Let's camp a day. Do I still have enough stuff for the fish on a stick? I do. Alright. Interesting. Now guess your age. I mean, I didn't see you yet, so how would I be able to tell? Okay, let me try to make a guess. You are older than 20. But younger than 25. No? There we go. You're very young. You're actually younger than 20? Oh. I don't know then. 19? So, what are we doing here? Easy, easy. We can always fight later. Let's talk first. Move one finger and we'll cut your bald hide to scraps. What you need. Yeah, right. the hell? Is this really... Look, it's a diplomacy role with a difficulty of 1. So basically you can never fail this. This is cool. The ruler of these lands wishes to show that all who inhabit them are like children to him. In his grace, he gifts you with this rare, noble drink. Wedtail, take the bottle of him. So, what's gonna happen to him? Uh-oh. The Werret falls to the ground, shaking with violent convulsions. Oops. That idiot, how predictable. They've killed one of ours, get him, boys. What a surprise. It didn't work. What a surprise. I would have never guessed. What you looking at? Finish me off. Pour the potion into the Werret's mouth. Here, take a sip of this first. Let's see if this actually helps the Werret. Did it? It doesn't say. Yeah, then. I guess it didn't really help. Oh, you are 16? Really? Oh, interesting. You seemed older than 16 to me. And that's a compliment. That is a compliment. You could be my dad? Oh, shit. Holy fuck, you're actually right. That's terrifying, dude. That's actually terrifying. Oh my god, no. No! Maybe I should try to find the elixir of youth now. Oh my god. Adopt me, please. I don't know about that. I would have to talk to my girlfriend about that. Oh yeah, by the way, I adopt this random dude from the internet. I hope that's fine with you. Yeah, sure, darling. Okay. Let's get back to this guy. I'm sure you would fit right in, yeah. Cause I'm German, my girlfriend is South Korean, and you are Hungarian, right? Or was it? Oh, it was Hungary, right? Where you're from. Oh, shit. Oh, wait, I already did that with the dog, yeah. The Werret died from taking the potion. Is that so? Huh. The Werret simply died in the Mudgun Rabbit. You see, my potion wasn't meant to do anything with mind, only the body. We'll need to go for one final test, it seems. We must try the potion on a human. An elf would do just fine as well, or a dwarf, or... Uh-oh. He drinks it himself. That is bad. I wonder if I can dispel the magic. Remove sickness?
Henceforth,
Well, that sucks ass. I don't want to kill him. Well, I mean, I have an autosave, so... So he doesn't actually die. You have to, like, basically beat him up. Okay. The potion clouded your mind. You attacked me. Gods, forgive an old man. I didn't know what I was doing. Okay. I never thought that potion could work in such a way, but... Still, it does seem to make one stronger. Thank you for all your help. Now I know how to iron out the wrinkles, I think. Okay, cool. So that actually ended in a good way. Who would have thought? Cool. Oh, Ukrainian. Yeah, okay. Wait, where does Ukrainia lie? Exactly. I mean, I know it's in the east somewhere, but... Ah, it's like... I'm really bad at geography. Yeah, I'm surprised too. I was pretty sure that I would kill him there, but you, I guess not. You're not working on any dangerous new potion, I hope. Okay. This dude is actually... Looks like he's fine now. Oops, no. I don't want that. Cool. So, we did that. That was a cute little side quest. Oh, yeah. In the east of Poland. Okay. All right, yeah.
That is not far.
I knew it, but it was either Hungary or Ukraine. Does it really matter, though? No, it doesn't. It's all the same. Which, I don't mean that in like the way that, oh, you know, like, everyone living in the East, they are all the same shitty people. I mean it in the way that, you know, it doesn't matter if you're like German, Hungarian, Ukrainian, French. Actually, maybe if you're French, but, just kidding. Yeah, it doesn't really matter. People are the same everywhere. So, yeah, I think, I mean, I guess we could go for, Tristian's companion quest, but let's do that later. Actually, I want to check out the, screw the enemies, I don't care. Wait, let's actually head to the east and look for Ukrainia. No, let's look for, Oh, wait, I cannot... Oh. I thought you would be able to cross here, but I guess not. Oh, that stinks.
I need to catch my breath.
In that case, let's go here.
I tire.
I just want to go, like, around here and, check out all the different roads we have access to. What? So because your country is twice as big as mine, it means you're twice as old, so you're basically the same age as me. I guess that makes sense.
May we have a moment of respite?
No, we cannot have a moment of rest or something. Yeah, see, these guys are turning into owlbears. Oh my god. The thing is, it doesn't even matter what they turn into, they just die. They die like in 2 seconds. Yeah, boy. Man, are you guys lucky that I wasn't able to evade this battle? You almost got me. It was really close. Okay, let's leave. Right side of my chest hurts. Oh no! It must be the H! I'm dying. Okay. Rest in peace, old man. Thanks. Oh, look. Oh! Oh, okay. That's interesting. So there's two new locations. I don't think I can. Can I get this one? It's not part of my kingdom, is it? Oh, it is! Oh, that's good. Wow, nice. Cool. Let's make sure that there's nothing on the way here. Oh, there is a random fight on the way. Okay, then. Come on, you stupid cultists.
Oh yeah, guys. There are some 6 adventurers and 2 giant wolves on the road. The adventurers seem like they're having like 100 different magic items and are really insanely strong. Let's fight them! Woohoo! Yeah, that's a good idea, leader. Good job.
So stupid.
Time to search for the spot to rest.
Oh, my ranged characters are getting exhausted. Need to camp. Right now, I'm actually trying to not waste time at all by camping too much. So I'm like always trying to at least travel, you know, as long as the fights are easy, the random encounters are easy, I'm gonna try to travel and keep traveling until the characters actually get exhausted, because that's the point where they get like really bad in battle. So, should I go to this hilltop trail? The thing is, this area is in the mountains again, so if I go there, it's probably gonna take like a long ass time to even travel. See what I mean? Like, my character icon thing, horsey creature, tabletop character, already slowed down because this is in the mountains. Yeah, see that? Takes like a long ass time. Can I get this? No, I can't. Okay. Can I now tell people that you are my dad? I don't know. I don't think I want to be called a dad just yet. I mean, I guess it's fine when, you know, like if you were a female and you called me daddy, then That's fine. But for a guy? I don't know. Whoa. Oh! An Elder Air Elemental. Ooh. 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 And there's two of them. How do you know that I'm not female? I guess I'm randomly assuming your gender. What the hell are you doing? Dude, this guy is super annoying. Okay. Okay. What can I do here? Let's activate Rage. Oh, let's also activate this. Wait, does this have any negative effect on my characters? While the aura is activated, creatures adjacent to the mirror take 2d6 damage per round. Does that mean my own characters as well? Let's try it out, I guess. Oh, yeah, okay. Well, that sucks. It actually has a very long range as well, so I guess I'm not gonna activate it.
This was not part of the plan. This was not part of the plan. This was not part of the plan.
Okay. Let's start healing.
This was not part of the plan.
Damn, that was annoying.
Magritium Turinos. Magritium Turinos. Magritium Turinos.
Head on.
Alright, back to full HP. And set this guy to using the magic missile wand. I would really want to be a female, to be honest. Just so that I could understand one of my old friends who isn't a friend now. Oh, okay. I don't know. I don't think you actually need to be a female yourself to understand females. I don't think so. It usually just takes a bit of, you know, a bit of fantasy and a bit of empathy to understand people, like understand their point of view. Also, I don't know if you really want to experience how it is to be on your period. I don't know about that, dude. Crooked teeth? How's that? Oh, let me guess. Yeah, okay. So this is actually the Varnholz territory. I cannot get over there. Shit. That sucks. There's nothing here. Okay.
I need to catch my breath.
I wonder if at some point you actually can get over here. It seems like it, alright. Like, why would there be stuff like the crooked teeth here? If you cannot access it at all. That makes no sense. Shit, I need to like... Okay, I was about to say, I want to see if something is going on in the kingdom. It looks like there isn't. So let's
time
keep
to search.
Let's keep going.
To rest.
What is the Hilltop Trail? You got a text saying the opposite thing? I mean, who am I? Who am I to say what is right, you know? It's just I don't think you need to be of like a specific gender to understand people, or like of a specific race to understand people. You just need to be informed about how those people live. And then it is likely that you are able to understand them. The hell are you? What? I cannot hunt here. So I guess we cannot rest here. Oh, that sucks.
All according to plan.
Sucks pretty bad. Hello? Anyone here? Shit, there's a cave.
I need to catch my breath.
I know, but we cannot rest here apparently. The hell is this? Whoa. Why is there like an almost jungle-like area inside this cave? With like burning fire and stuff. Oh wait, that's not fire, that's... Oh. Ooh, some kind of weird red glowing land.
Time to search for the spot to rest.
Hello, cat. Whoa, 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 whoa! What's going on? Whoa! These kitties can teleport.
At your death.
May we have a moment of respite?
Maybe I can actually camp in this cave, however. This looks like it should be... What the fuck? A portal? Oh, that is interesting. Okay. That's very interesting. Let's see. Now we cannot hunt here. Fuck. Let's keep going then. The good thing is, Emiri actually has this new necklace that makes her unable to get tired, you know? Actually, what happens if I give this to another character? Ah, okay. that would have been a great cheat, that you could just basically get rid of the exhaustion. By just switching around the necklace. Well, devs are smart enough to not do that.
I tire.
Well, let's use this portal. I have no idea where this is gonna lead, but... Whoa, okay. That looks interesting.
All according to plan.
Traces of armor plus 5. Ooh.
Something bothering you?
Mana plus 4, right? Yeah, okay, cool. Do I want to give it to her? Do I want to give it to him? I don't know. I mean, I guess we want him to stay alive more, because he's the healer. Then again, I mean... with such a low AC, like, it's almost not even worth to think about, you know? Like, why do all of your characters look like main characters? What do you mean?
I shall end this.
What's your definition of a main character look? Whoa. Whoa! Oh, fuck me! Dude! This one is smart! He's teleporting to my backline. Whoa. Okay. Okay. I see. Oh, fuck. Fuck. No, no, no. No. Don't do it. No. Ah! Oh, shit, dude. Dude, this is cool. I mean, this makes it really hard, but this is cool. I like how that guy is actually smart about that. Oh, shh. Okay, guys. We need to get buffed up for this. Holy crap. Oh, actually, we might be able to win.
Let us strike as one.
I need to pull back with her. She doesn't get any
not dead yet.
Any minus 4 rolls. Shit. Lucy magic.
Do not falter. This is for you.
Come on. Yes.
I tire.
All right.
I'm listening.
Woo. That was cool. I think that's the first time in this game this actually happened. Yeah, I like that a lot. It's cool to see that they have like
right here, my friend.
They have, you know, such AI in the game that actually does, like, cool stuff like that. Oh, see? He had an amulet. Amulet of Mighty Fist plus 1? Oh, fuck. Yeah. That sucks. Okay, we don't have a monk. It doesn't really help. Radiant AI from Oblivion.
In due time.
Yeah, like, so far the AI in this game, like, everyone was really stupid. Like, they would always attack the first, you know, the first playable character in my party they saw. So it was very easy to have them attack the tank. But now we see that probably later on in the game it will always be like that. Like, the enemies actually making like decisions like, oh yeah, let's actually attack the people in the back row first.
As it should be.
It's kind of cool. So that was interesting. The portal actually led us into another world. Now, if I knew about Pathfinder lore, I could probably recognize this world. Yeah, that was interesting. In a fucking random cave in the mountains, I found this portal.
We should gather our strength.
Yeah, I know.
All according to plan.
But I cannot rest. I cannot camp. They don't let me. It's kind of bad that the only thing we got is like a necklace that is essentially useless for my characters, because it's really only good for monks.
in due time.
That is not true. It's good for monks, and it's good for people who actually transform into animal forms. Like, it would be good for a druid as well, because it would boost your damage in an animal form. But yeah,
that is not far.
No one of us is doing that. Nothing? Okay. Well, let's get out of here then. That's cool. La 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 la. So, but it's here that leads. Oh, wait, what if I go this way? This probably leads to Varnhold as well. Yeah, see? Already been there, so I don't give a fuck. Oh. Okay, now I definitely need to. Oh shit. Oh my, this is the path that leads up here. Oh my god, dude. This takes so long. Okay, we need to camp. We need to camp. Hell yeah. Okay, I wonder what this is. This was a really difficult location to get to. Not just because it takes like a very long time to even get here, because you have to go through all the mountains. It was also like a very hard to spot road, I would say. Like, look, it was like kind of hidden back here. So that is interesting. I wonder what this is. The Talon Peak. Probably some kind of giant dragon will just eat me now. Well, it's definitely kind of snowy.
All according to plan.
And they make it look like we're actually climbing a mountain. That's cool. Oh shit, spiders.
Repent.
I did not expect spiders.
This should do it.
For all the stuff up here, I did not expect spiders. What the fuck? Aren't spiders supposed to hate the cold climate?
A calculated risk. Enemy approaching.
Oh no! A spider swarm? Remember that shit from the very beginning of the game? Oh no, dude. Oh no. Well, maybe I can actually hit them now. Oh. Okay. Well, that was way easier than before. Okay. Okay. Random stuff. Yeah, I guess my accuracy is now so high that I can even hit swarms really easily. The problem at the beginning of the game was that I was unable to hit these swarms at all. Empty notebook. Oh, yeah.
In due time.
Well, that is good to know. Now I can actually kill swarms.
I'm not afraid.
Yes. Keep going. Oh shit, she got poisoned. Actually, it wasn't poison, it was...
That is not far.
She was just being nauseous. It's not too bad. Wait, what? Now we are climbing down again. The hell? Was this the area? If yes, then that was pretty disappointing.